Tamil Nadu. The southeastern state of India is home to the city of Chennai, situated along the world's second longest beach. A suburb of Chennai has a major road called the Old Mahabalipuram Road, or OMR as it is called. This road houses many information technology companies and is therefore popularly called the Information Technology Corridor. These companies have forever changed the landscape of the villages of the Chennai suburbs. The migration of professionals to this area and their concomitant needs have led to the development of infrastructure and the incessant supply of goods and services in some pockets of this region, while some areas are still left behind. One can therefore observe fascinating and contrasting images that exist side by side in the villages along this major highway. You can see concrete roads and mud paths, luxury apartments and huts with thatched roofs, homes with no proper cooking facilities, and houses that are completely Wi-Fi enabled, construction of high-rise buildings, and the sowing of saplings in lush green fields. The villages of OMR are populated with many people who are so diverse in nature. All of them, while so very different in age, gender, color, caste, creed, education, and economic status, are all connected by one thing.
Empowered by technology, you are connecting and collaborating like never before on Facebook and WhatsApp and Twitter.
Yes, they are all connected by social media. They are all collaborating as users of Facebook, WhatsApp, and Twitter. They are all networking in a manner that transforms their lives. To understand the way in which people use social media, we have spoken to housewives and mothers, students and children, entrepreneurs and farmers. And what do they say? Let's find out. Family is believed to be one of the strongest social units in Indian society. Today, migration and travel have frequently separated close family members. However, for many Indians, social media bridges these long distances. A swipe on the iPad, a tap on the keyboard, or a touch of a phone connects sisters and brothers, sons and mothers, aunts and nephews.
I have friends in Facebook, not only my friends, my relatives also, my cousins, my nephews, who are younger, much younger to me. Because they are placed in different places, far away, one of them, most of them in abroad. So I be in touch with them and I come to know what is happening around, how they settled there, and I come to know about their places because they send a lot of pictures. I got a grandchild recently, so I was able to tell all my friends. Instead of calling everyone or mailing everyone, I found it comfortable and easy to convey this about my grandchild, and everyone congratulated me and they came to know that I become a grandma. WhatsApp, and I have my family group, like we have a Shriram group, so we have a lot of people, it's countless, because all my cousins, sisters, brothers, everyone is there. This is my family Shriram group, where we post everything, right from the birth of a child or anything, or the functions, how we celebrate, and those pictures and everything. That's what we discuss here. We share everything, good or bad, and some quiz, everything. One of my eldest sister, who is not a techie person, she hardly uses the mobile. We made her join the group, and she started posting pictures and messages. In fact, recently she's gone to Mansarovar. So she was having a chat with us. It is very interesting to know. And in fact, her son posted she is fine. And we are able to know immediately what is happening around, because it is very far away. We are so worried how she is able to handle it. So that way it helps a lot. Hangout, and through that we used to chat. I was able to see my grandchild moving around, and romba interesting ah irundhathu. So I really miss her, because in the hangout la paathavane I am so happy that I'm not missing certain things except the feel of my grandchild. Okay, so in this way it helped me a lot, this G chat. And in fact, I am planning to talk with more people, more to my relatives who are abroad. So instead of a phone call, you talk to them and you also see them. Family la one new entrant to our family, that is my sister's daughter-in-law. She got married, but for her marriage, many of my cousins, some of my family members were not there. But through WhatsApp group, she was able to know who is who and how they are related, and she has become very close. So she calls them Anna, and she is very attached, and she sends a lot of messages, congratulates them, and convey her greetings for their birthdays and wishing them. It is quite interesting. This was a wish from my youngest member of my family to my daughter on her birthday. She generally wishes everyone the same way. Others will just type the message, but whereas she is very particular that she will wish everyone through voice. Okay.
Happy birthday Arjunathai, happy birthday Arjunathai, happy birthday Arjunathai, happy birthday to you.
When we are abroad, we are at least able to hear their voice, and it is refreshing, like when you hear someone wishing you more than messages, voice.
Actually, my niece, she only downloaded this app, WhatsApp. She only told me, because the younger generation now, we don't know. So she told, auntie, please, I will download this for you. It will be very helpful for you. So she downloaded only WhatsApp. If now anything happens here, I immediately WhatsApp her. Like my daughter now took in Independence Day program, so I sent that video to her, and she was very happy. And once my daughter took part in MasterChef in school, they are teaching without fire some bhel puri or sandwiches. So she brought that thing in tiffin, and I clicked that photo and I send it to my niece through WhatsApp only. So she become very happy for that. Nephew got married in Punjab, and I could not go because of exams of kids. So they sent me all photographs through WhatsApp. So I got all the photographs there.
Family வந்து ஃபேமிலின்னு வச்சிருக்கோம். ஃபேமிலி அப்படி PHAMIL நிறைய நிறைய பேர் இருக்கும். அதனால் ஃபேமிலின்னு வச்சுருக்கோம். வி ஹவ் ஆல் ஓவர் இந்தியா அப்ராட் இருக்க எல்லாருமே வி ஆர் கனெக்டட். அண்ட் மை பிரதர் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அப்ராட், ஸோ ஐ ஹார்ட்லி கெட் டு சீ தெம். ஸோ எனக்கு வாட்ஸ்அப் மூலயமா, அதாவது நெக்ஸ்ட் டோரில் இருக்க மாதிரி ஃபோன் பண்ணி பேச முடியாது, அவ்வளோ துட்டெல்லாம் செலவு பண்ண முடியாது. ஸோ ISD காலுக்கெல்லாம் ஸோ வாட்ஸ்அப்னாக்கா வாய்ஸ் மெசேஜ் விடலாம், லூஸ் தனமாக கத்தலாம், யாரும் ஒன்றும் சொல்ல மாட்டாங்க, அவங்க நான் கத்துறேன் அவங்க கேட்குறாங்க, அவ்வளோதான். இட்ஸ் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ஃபன், வாட்ஸ்அப் இஸ் ஃபன்.
எஸ், சோஷியல் மீடியா ஹெல்ப்ஸ் அ லவ்விங் சிஸ்டர் கேட்ச் அப் வித் ஹர் பிரதர் லிவிங் அப்ராட், கனெக்ட்ஸ் அ வரிங் சன் வித் அன் ஓல்ட் மதர் ஆன் அ பில்கிரிமேஜ் அண்ட் can circulate the cherubic birthday greetings from a young child to family members. Juggling is an activity that involves multiple tasks, perfect execution, and elements of surprise. The modern-day women are perfect jugglers, creating surprise birthday parties, festival celebrations, and community events, while simultaneously managing their professions and family, as you will now see.
One nice thing is that if any friend is having a birthday, so leaving, barring that one friend, we make a group for that event, so that we can celebrate the birthday of that friend for that occasion. So we all will be chatting that, okay, we are going to get a cake or we are getting this. Everybody will put an input, but the only member whose birthday wouldn't be there in that group. So that will be an occasional group which gets closed as soon as the birthday is over. So groups are there of many sort, actually.
Just like that Lodi we did. So we made one group for that. So yeah, we have to meet in this at this time, this place. So we used to chat in that only, all that planning and all. Even for Independence Day, we had two groups added, the dance group that I did, Rang De Basanti, and that Shalala dance group. All that moms were in WhatsApp, all the names were there. So, okay, today program practice is in this block, that place, this timing, and about costume discussion, all happened in WhatsApp only. Because they don't have time to come. Only few ladies came, but few ladies were busy in their office work and all, so they didn't come. So through WhatsApp only they got all the information.
Yeah, Independence Day activity, we had an Independence Day program. So in that WhatsApp has really helped, because we could communicate in various ways. There were many groups of children who were dancing. First of all, for every event, every dance, we had formed a group. There were about some 10 dances, so there were new 10 groups which were formed for the event. So we exactly knew who are the parents and who are the children. Parents were obviously the people who were enrolled, because children won't have a WhatsApp or a mobile, because this pertained to the age of 3 to 12, 13 years old children. So what happened, whenever the kids used to come or there is a practice time, a message is to go to that group. According to the, some ladies actually took the charge of, teaching the children the dance and how to go about the event. So they used to post that this is the time today, the dance practice is between 6 to 7 at this venue. So once they posted in that group, in any which group, the parents would come to know and they could, communicate and they could send the kids. At the same time, when the dance was over, it would be communicated, the dance is over, please come and pick up your children. So all the parents would come. So this has helped in making this Independence Day program a success, in the sense that everybody came, kids came in time, left in time, and we ensured that everybody secured. It's not that the children have just left from somewhere and they've gone out somewhere. We would inform the parents that the dance is over, they would come and collect the children. So in that way, there were 10 groups formed for this.
In different buildings also.
In different buildings.
That would be communicated properly.
So because the children are coming from all the blocks, towers of our apartment. So in that case, it was very easy to communicate. As well as the dress, the costumes or any props, we could just discuss. A person who is handling one particular dance, that lady or the person would easily communicate with all the parents at one time. that we have gone ahead with this dance till there, and we request such a costume. Does everybody have? They can ask suggestion from the parents. Shall we use this prop? So that has helped in a big way, and our Independence Day program has become a success because of this. It was presented
very beautifully communicated.
Very beautiful.
And the core committee had a team. Okay, we wouldn't do anything without the core committee being informed.
Yeah.
So whatever these team members, they would be related to our committee. They would inform us, and then in turn we'll sit and plan the entire program. So it gave us a clear picture of how to plan and execute it. So it was very easy for us.
Yes, for these women, WhatsApp has been the perfect tool for event management while juggling their roles of a working woman, a community resident, and a mother. When moving into a new apartment, the harried Indian women are searching for a helpline that readily provides for their domestic needs, such as hiring a chauffeur or plumber, locating a grocery store, or a pediatrician. Can social media save the day?
In our apartment, we are having 2-3 groups. There's a group called a park group, where the people whom we meet in the park, those ladies, we have formed a group. You know, are you coming down? What time? Like that, that kind of a group. And another group is a womania group. So, which is, of course, we are generally in a place, you know, where the women are chatting. Not that the men cannot.
Only women. Yeah, yeah. All groups are like that only. No men. No men are allowed. All ladies group.
But Womania group is having about 50 members from our apartment, where we chat about what is happening in the apartment, as well as jokes and information and things like that.
Womania group is a gang of Hira group, where she is also there and I am also there.
So it is related to the apartment where we are staying. It is that is generally a communication and an information passing center. It is not a very personal inside kind of a group, though we have fun in that also. We would post, you know, every day morning there will be a good morning message, a prayer, a picture of a god. It starts with that, and there will be some jokes, you know, from a few people who generally keep on posting. But mostly it is used for passing information. If suppose a child got very sick suddenly in the night, so the lady actually asked, do you know any pediatrician, because she was new to Chennai. So immediately one of the 50, you know, somebody replied and gave the number so that lady could, you know, communicate to the doctor. So in that way, many, you know, 3-4 people who had fallen sick for a pediatrician or for a neurologist and things like that, people have guided. Those people who are living in Chennai. So it's very helpful in that way. As well as, you know, since we have come to this place, to a newer place, so we don't know about the surroundings much. So people who are moving in newly, they are asking for vendors, where is the grocery shop and where is the, you know, where we can get the non-veg and things like that. So a lot of information. Even this gang of womania is even called the yellow pages of our apartment, because we get a lot of information, which is very, very helpful. If somebody doesn't have a maid, wants a maid, so they will just pass on a message. Do anybody have a maid who's having some time to come and work? So it has become a very, very helpful network.
Gangs of Womania is there. That is a full common that group, in which if you have any problem, you need any maid, you can post it. If you have any problem, you can post it in that. So that is very lifeline of this complex for us, actually. Anybody wants any help, okay, where is this doctor, do you have any homeopathy number, or some plumber, car driver, any sort of information, it is like yellow pages. So this group is not more fun, but it is more of information. Just now we got one information that 27th August there will be 2 moons on the sky, 12:30 at night, and it comes after so many years that it will be maybe we will be not alive that time, next when it will come. So these information all comes in WhatsApp. So these are very informative.
First group who is there, who is a coordinator, one member will be connected to the second group. Okay, the second group, one member will be connected, she will be connected to, the first and the second. Yeah. The third group person will be connected in the first group also, she will be there in the second group also, and she will have the whole the third group. But she will not be the group ID, group admin of the first group. Because in case the group admin doesn't see the message, it shouldn't stop there. The message has to be forwarded. So immediately, even if I'm in the first group as well as in the second group, group admin. Okay. So the third group admin is the person who is there in first and the second and the third. Because when I don't get time to forward, suppose if I'm in a place where my 3G is off or my no Wi-Fi network, nothing, then she will immediately pass on. It doesn't stop. Just because that one person is not there, we don't stop the information.
For these women, their Womania WhatsApp group is their lifeline and yellow pages. Today, YouTube seems to be a medium that is used both for entertainment and learning. The following clips show how some use YouTube for watching video songs, while others use it to learn singing and dancing.
YouTube is a really good site if you want to look at videos or highlights of something you missed, or anything actually. YouTube is really large. And a few friends of mine also have their own channels, so I follow them.
YouTube is very good for, as far as I use, is for music, to see music videos and listening to songs. And whenever I remember of any good song or something like that, and I want to see how the video is, I would go to YouTube for music.
This house, which is completely Wi-Fi enabled, has become a digitally connected space where Pooja is able to access YouTube on her television. This gives her the luxury of watching her favorite song on a large screen anytime she wants, within the comforts of her home.
I study in class 7. School is HUS. I am 11 years old. I choreographed a song for Independence Day with the help of YouTube. So I typed the song which I want to listen to. The song's name is Desh Rangila. I would like to show you some steps of the song I choreographed.
While playing and pausing, forwarding and rewinding the song, Pooja memorizes the verses, syncs her lips to the lyrics, and rehearses the steps of the song. For Pooja, YouTube has become her very own tutorial of Bollywood dancing. With marriage and motherhood, there comes a time in a woman's life to wave goodbye to carefree days and fun times. Wives and mothers go through life making countless sacrifices, all the while with questions whispering inside their heads. Will I ever get to relive the fun days of my childhood? Will I ever feel the joy of bonding with friends over a good meal? Will I ever experience the banter and jokes that I once shared with my friends in college? Let us find out their answers.
We have a group which is a fun group which is called Saruka Singari. It means beautiful ladies, drunk beautiful ladies. If I'm not wrong, this is the actual meaning of the group, and it is not that everybody is drinking every day. It is just for fun that we generally dress up and we go out and we have fun, and that is a total fun group. This group is a fantastic, and the bonding between all of us is just like sisters. Though we don't know each other from earlier, like we met each other in the apartment, but it is like we all are sisters, and we can share all our secrets, and we are assured that nobody is going to talk about it or gossip about it elsewhere. It is a completely closed, happy group.
Actually, this group, we all got in like while doing the Christmas carnival. We just met one after the other. I met her in Christmas carnival. She was my support. அப்புறம் சப் ஹெல்ப் பண்ணுறதுக்குன்னு ரெண்டு பேர் வந்தாங்க. ஓகே, அண்ட் ஆல்ரெடி ரெண்டு பேர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸாக இருந்தோம். ஸோ அந்த வேவ் லென்த் வந்து குறும்பு பண்ணால் அந்த குறும்புக்கு தக்க மாதிரி வி ஹேட் நாட்டியஸ்ட் விமன். வி கேன் பி ஃபேமிலி விமன் அட் த சேம் டைம் த பிராட்ஸ். ஸோ 10 பேரும் ஒன்றா சேர்ந்தால் தெர் இஸ் நோ சீக்ரெட். இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு பி mad, we will behave mad, and that remains in the group. It doesn't go out of the group. And the interesting part is she's a Hindi speaking lady, na Tamil, ala rendu mallus onnu bong appuram oru rendu Tamilians, and idhila illama nanga UK la rendu vera vechirukom.
Yeah, there are two friends who are from UK,
who are from UK,
but they are in daily correspondence with us. Equally. So that's what we generally communicate in English, mostly. But if it's the fun of the group is that few of us don't understand Tamil properly. So whoever will write anything in Tamil, there will be a translation in the bracket in English so that we don't miss out on understanding the thing. So that understanding is very good.
Biryani event, that was a Thanksgiving event. Okay, because this Independence Day we did, and one lady wanted to call all of us, the sponsor, the organizers. Volunteers and the organizers, and to give biryani. Man, we can't do good biryani, so whatever we can't cook well, shamelessly we'll go and eat in somebody else's house. So adukku or thaniya or a group vachu. So that group will call us, and they invited us. Alla Saraka Singaris la irundhu moonu volunteers irundhom. So all the three of us went. When all the three of us went, baaki Saraka Singari la summa vidala. You are all not invited. We are invited for biryani.
And the new group name is Mermaid, because Mermaid group was the biryani group. So we give some nice, jolly and funny names. And the other Saraka Singari ladies who were not invited, we nicely told them, we tempted them for the food, but we all went. So that kind of a fun, we tease each other as well as we love each other so much. For such events, for biryani parties or any get-togethers, like we both are working, we both take a day off. I took a day off from my work, but I wouldn't miss meeting my friends, and this all happens because of a good communication. We don't miss out on catching up with friends. So I left my work aside for a day. Definitely I'd catch up tomorrow with the work, but I went for this party because of having fun with friends.
I have clients every day in, day out. I have clients, and they don't inform me before. So if they don't inform me before, I don't mind skipping that client off when I've got an appointment with my girls. நம்ம சொல்லுவோம் இல்லையா, என்ன அந்த 40 மேலே கேர்ள் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். சின்ன வயசில் பாய் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் வேர் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். ஆஃப்டர் 40 இட் இஸ் த கேர்ள் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ். ஐம் டெல்லிங் யூ, யூ கவுண்ட் ஹவு மெனி கேர்ள்ஸ் யூ ஹேவ், யூ ஹேவ் த பெஸ்ட் ஃபன். ஏன்னா டு பி வெரி ஆனஸ்ட், ஐ நெவர் ஹேட் கேர்ள் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் இன் மை லைஃப். திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் செட் ஆஃப் கேர்ள் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் வேர் ஐம் என்ஜாயிங். And இவ்வளோ கூட குறும்பு பண்ணலாமா அப்படிங்கிற அளவுக்கு ஐ என்ஜாய். ஸோ இட் இஸ் லைக் இட்ஸ் த வாட்ஸ்அப் விச் இஸ் ப்ராட் பீப்புள் ஃப்ரம் அதர் கண்ட்ரீஸ் ஆல்சோ, லைக் ஈவன் இஃப் தேர் லிவிங் அவே ஃப்ரம் யூ, தே ஆர் ஆல்சோ வித் அஸ். ஈக்குவலி வி ஆர் ஆல் கம்யூனிகேட்டிங் டு ஈச் அதர். ஸோ வி டோன்ட் மிஸ் அவுட் ஆன் எனிபடி. இட்ஸ் லைக் அ ஃபேமிலி. நாங்கள் நல்லா எங்கள் வீட்டுக்காரங்களாம் திட்டுவோம். வி கிவ் தம் லெஃப்ட் ரைட் அண்ட் சென்டர் பிகாஸ் டைரக்ட்லி வி கான் ஸ்கோல்டு த மென் அட் ஹோம் த பிரெட் வின்னர்ஸ் பட் ஸ்டில் வி ஹாவ் தட் லிபர்ட்டி டு ஸ்கோல் தம் ஒன்லி இன் வாட்ஸ்அப் வித் அவர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ். ஸோ வி கிவ் தம் மவுத் ஃபுல் ஹார்ட் ஃபுல் இன் வாட்ஸ்அப் அண்ட் தென் வீல் சே புவர் புவர் கைஸ் யா அண்ட் தென் வி கெட் பேக் டு தெம் ரியல் லைஃப் தே ஆர் த கைஸ் ஹூ ஆர் வித் அஸ்
So we vent out our anger on the WhatsApp instead of showing it to the husband. So it gets over within the friends. And it's a quite a good way to have happiness in a family. Without the man knowing that we are angry, we just vent it out and it's gone. Like it's a happy day. If somebody is very angry, then she would, you know, she would abuse enough.
Good abuse.
And send, you know, not to us. For the husband or for whoever.
Suppose we didn't like somebody in the other group, okay? You can't go and scold them in the other group. So in this group, all bad words we'll use. And, there are a couple of people who don't know Tamil, right? So we teach all the bad words, how to teach, how to scold people on the road also. Like, you know, how to, ipa pathina, pora nadari, teruporki, like that, you know? We teach all bad, dirty words to all our friends. We'll text them in English. You know, to teach them, get them trained in Tamil, how to scold them. This is not for the husbands, okay? This is for those people who are very bad behaviors in the road, on the road actually.
Yeah, that happens in WhatsApp.
So, when these women ask the questions, will I ever get to relive the fun days of my childhood? Will I ever feel the joy of bonding with friends over a good meal? Will I ever experience the banter and jokes that I once shared with my friends in college? Did they find the answer? They certainly did. And the answer was a resounding yes, thanks to social media. For some people, social media provides the platform to pursue some interesting hobbies.
Even it is an encouragement for art also, because so many pictures are in circulation, very, very beautiful pictures, like some artwork in some, that craft work in food, that vegetables, or I have one photograph, that apple craft, that very nice, and even very beautiful photography things are there. So many photos are coming. That is the encouragement for art only. I have so many beautiful pictures in WhatsApp. I don't want to delete them because they are related to arts. Some are vegetable carving or fruits carving. They are so beautiful that it's not possible for me to delete. So I keep it safe. And even some trick photography are there, photographic pictures are there. So I keep them safe because I like to watch and watch again and again. So it's beautiful to have in WhatsApp all these pictures. Some ladies put puzzle also in WhatsApp. Sometime picture puzzle or sometime mathematical problems or sometime like sentence puzzles are there. So I like to solve the problems and everybody likes it. So it is very interesting, all these puzzles.
In the Indian society, where parents decide even the marriage partners of their children, it is not surprising to see their desire to control their children's use of social media. Some welcome it, while some are wary. The following video clips present a mosaic of opinions on children being on social media from the perspectives of a parent and a child.
See, my husband is not at all in technology. He doesn't know anything about computer. If you will ask anything, he doesn't know anything. Even about mobile, he will buy the high-end mobile, which is the latest mobile in the market. but he doesn't know how to use it. Only email, calling, message, SMS, that's all. Nothing else he knows about that. And he only depend on my son only. That if he wants to do something, then he will call. Beta, please come and do this and that. If I want to buy some online products, then I call him. Then he showed me. Nowadays also I tell him to do all this thing, because I don't know much about that technology. That is very useful in computer now, online shopping and all. Oh, he is in 9th standard. Just now only he got, 1 month ago only. Samsung only. I don't know that which one, but he got now only. After so many years, now he was behind us. Give me phone. We didn't, but now we thought, okay, he is in 9th standard, we should give now. I don't prefer, but he is there. Because it's like addiction. We are addicted, I know. I was not like that, but now I have become. So I don't, because they have to study. Now we are free, we don't have any work. We have to cook in the morning and then after that we are free. So we can use, we can spend time like this, but they have to study. So my son is not having WhatsApp. I told him, you cannot download WhatsApp because you have to study. I don't know, then these days though, this generation is fully, I don't know from where they get all this knowledge. They know much, much more than us. We thought that, we are thinking that they are still small kid, but no, they are not. They are much aware about this technology, everything. Maybe through Google or somewhere, I don't know. Maybe through friends. She used YouTube to listen that Barbie songs and all. Otherwise, I don't allow her. Mostly, I don't allow her to watch YouTube. No. I told you na that for my son also we gave now only that smartphone. But still, I'm not very happy. And even my husband also not happy that we have given mobile to him. But what to do? Because everybody is having, so we have to give, and they don't listen, na. That's why.
Yeah, I think in the days to come, the children would be. As of now, if you ask, I wouldn't want my daughter to be in the Facebook because she may get exposed to some wrong information, wrong videos, because people post videos and other stuff on the WhatsApp also. So I wouldn't want her to be, but I don't think so I can stop it. It's quite inevitable that all the kids are going to be on the social network in the coming future, because they are more tech savvy and they know much more than what we know. When we are being grown up people, we are getting addicted, so I'm sure the kids are going to be. So as of now, I wouldn't want, but once she grows and if I think that she's sensible enough to think and judge what she should do in her life and she's able to judge what is good and bad, I don't mind her to be on WhatsApp or Facebook.
In our pasangla, but I have two boys. So the elder one is in 10th standard and the younger one is in 7th standard. 7th standard la irukavanukku vandha, he has got Facebook account also. And my elder one is into Facebook and WhatsApp. But nanga adu kudukumbode only one thing we said, you know, you be truthful to yourself. You know what is right and what is not right. So you choose what you want to be. Everybody has got a choice. So if you choose to be on the right path, you can go ahead. And my children have, you know, I'm very privileged to say that, you know, they have added us as friends, because we don't hide anything from each other. Even whatever my love life or whatever I have come through, whatever I've faced, we have openly discussed with my children. So both my kids know what their parents were and what they are. Me and my husband, both of us are their Facebook friends. And whatever they comment, we also know. Whatever their girlfriends also comment, we know. And we openly discuss everything. So we don't have anything, you know. And when he went to HMU and also, he had lot of, through Facebook, he picked up lot of people who had participants of HMU. This Hyderabad, the mock United Nation. They went as a delegates from different countries. So that helped him reach out to a lot of people from different countries. He met people from Pakistan. Even before he reached Hyderabad, he met a lot of people. Facebook, United Nation group e irukku thaniya. So they help the children who are starting new, how to go about, how to present a session. So all that I wouldn't stop him from.
I'm in 10th grade right now. Facebook, I was actually exposed to it while I was very young. I was probably 9 or 10 when I got onto Facebook. I did it myself, but under the supervision of my dad, because he wasn't too sure I should do it at that point. But then I was pretty insistent, so he agreed finally. My brother and I used to share an account. My parents are really, they don't mind if I do anything, because I know they're always there to advise me if I go wrong anywhere. And anything that I want to hide from my parents is obviously something I'm not supposed to be doing. So I don't feel a reason to hide anything from my parents.
On the one hand, parents restrict their children's use of social media, but on the other hand, they look up to these very same children to overcome their technological handicaps. Similarly, the parents curtail their children's use of social media while fully recognizing their own addiction to it. So as you can see, children on social media, it's complicated. Indian women are stereotyped as the indecisive shopaholics who spend hours to decide what to buy. They are often the butt of ridicule in Tamil cinema. The following clip from a Tamil film vividly captures this scenario. This is one way to shop. Shall we now see how the tech-savvy women handle their shopping decisions today?
I went for shopping for somebody's gift. So I was very confused what to buy. What I did, I asked that lady, can I click photograph? She said yes. Then I clicked three photographs and I sent to my husband. And it will tell me which one is good. Then he told me, okay, this is good, then I took that. So this is very, very, very convenient. Na?
Suppose they will ask to buy some gifts or cakes, I will share the picture with you. This cake is okay, I will share it with WhatsApp.
A lot of shopping happens if we are not able to go together. So that helps in a major shopping actually goes. You know, they would buy, you choose some 4 dresses or 4 things and send a picture which one is good. And we can fairly have an idea of what the person is purchasing. And even if we're buying gifts for our friends, you know, one of them goes to buy and WhatsApp to the group, you know, we say, okay, this is good, that is not good. If my husband has gone for shopping, for buying something, he would send me pictures from the mall because I could not assist him or go with him. He would send the picture and say which one is good, you know.
Today, thanks to WhatsApp, the Indian woman can go shopping alone and still have a collective decision on the purchase by consulting her friends and family through WhatsApp. Similarly, the Indian husband is also aided by WhatsApp while picking a dress for his choosy wife. The creative talents and business aspirations of Indian women are sapped by the drudgery of domestic chores in many Indian houses. Today, social media has joined hands with many such women, thereby turning a creative person into a successful professional and a home cook into a small-time entrepreneur.
Personally, I feel Facebook is one of the best things that could have happened to me because I started promoting my page on Facebook, Tailspin, a platform for stories, and I can vehemently say, if I may use that word, that Facebook page of Tailspin has pretty much made me famous as a storyteller, because many a time I get calls from people who have been searching for a storyteller in Chennai. And when I asked them where they found my number or where they found me, they would simply say, ma'am, we Googled for a storyteller in Chennai and your name and your number came up. And then we saw your page and we liked what we saw there, the photographs, and that is why we are calling you. So I think I have a lot of love for the Facebook because it's made me who I am partly. But for Tailspin, where I promote much of my storytelling sessions, it is not only promoting my own sessions through photographs and through information where my next sessions are going to be held. It is also because I'm passionate about bringing back oral storytelling tradition. I post a lot of links which are similar to mine, stories and links of storytellers who have been kind enough to post so much of information, categorizing stories into various categories, so to say, so that it's easy for people to pick. And many a time I do get people either posting a message to me or telling me when I meet them that I'm so thankful to you because I found this story. I was looking for a story and your links helped me find that story. And I am very active on Facebook. You can check from my family. I spend quite a number of hours, maybe 4 to even 5 hours in a day on internet, not only on Facebook, but on the internet, Googling for a lot of things. A lot of my stories I Google when I have a particular theme in mind or somebody asks me, then it is Google is the first thing I go in for. That is the search engine I use. And I am definitely happy about it because I do get the story I want online. And my post on my own page, Tailspin, it is almost every other day. The maximum I think I have not posted is probably 3 or 4 days when I've been out of town. I believe that a storytelling session should be interactive. And I would like to think that I have a unique style of telling the stories when I draw my audience into my story, because that is a separate world we are in. When I'm telling the story as a teller and they as listeners are listening to the story, it is just like what I call the story world. We are in the story world at that point in time. So for them to be actively in that story, I want them to interact with me. So I emote either with gestures or with my voice. I sing songs, I even dance. I have absolutely no inhibition when I'm telling a story, as long as my story can carry to my audience. And during that interaction, I request the audience to interact with me either through repeating the songs or through any action. So many of the photographs that I post online in the Tailspin page is where the audience has interacted with me. I do not prefer just my photographs just with just my face there because that is not what I want. I want people who look at that page and that photograph to feel that yes, the audience is also in the story as much as the teller is in that story. So, and that is an experience that I think I want to give to people who see this online, and maybe they will be drawn to a storyteller somewhere in their own place, and that way I hope I'm helping and reviving the oral tradition in some way. I'd like to think that. See, in the course of storytelling, much as I love the audience to be involved, I also, think that you should be able to stop and answer queries, especially when you are with children and they are intelligent by the day and they are curious. So I would like a storytelling session, when I mean interactive, I should be open to their questions, to be able to answer their questions. And this interesting incident happened during this Madras day. One of the children asked me when I said how the name changed from Madras to Chennai. I did it in a personal way that I was Madras. So I said, my name somewhere along the line got changed to Chennai. A child immediately asked, Auntie, can you tell me when was this? At that instant, I forgot the year. I wanted to answer that child's question. It is not that I wanted to continue the story, but more that the child needs to know the answer. And I asked a couple of the adults, the parents who were there, they didn't know, but the gentleman, one of the kids' father, Googled straight away and he told me it was in the year 1996 or 98. So even now I'm forgetting the year. But I answered the child's query then and there. And I know that I had a better listener at that point in time. So that is what makes life as a storyteller interesting for me. As I tell, and I really don't know what surprises I will get as I go along telling a story. But I would definitely love to be an interactive storyteller, but to be known as an interactive storyteller, where I can stop my story and answer children's queries then and there, you know, and still continue with the story, because then I know, like I said, that child or that participant is now a better listener. I believe that I'm still learning in the field of storytelling. I'm learning every day, and to post my own audio and videos on Facebook, I have a set standard for myself in my mind. I need to achieve that standard before I feel comfortable posting it on, posting my videos and audios either on YouTube or any of the other social media pages, even Facebook for that matter, or Tailspin page. And as for posting others' videos or audio links, I need to write to them and ask their permission. Pretty much now the text content, when I ask people for permission, when I write to them, mail them, they are very happy to share and say, you can go ahead and post it. It's always nice when people come up and give you compliments for anything in life, so I'm no different. When somebody comes up to me and says your story was good and or we enjoyed the story or the way you said it, it really boosts me and I want to tell more stories. It motivates me, it encourages me. And this letter, though people have said it and a few of them also posted, have posted, if you kind of browse through the Tailspin page, you will get some good compliments from people. But this one particularly, it's just about less than a week ago that I got to see this, because the library where I did this story had a lot of children and they were celebrating their first anniversary, and they invited me to tell a story for their clients. And there was this child who was there in that session, he has apparently written a letter which he has showed it to the managers of the library, and the owners have been kind enough to put it up on their page. And once I saw it there, it was actually another storytelling colleague of mine who actually told me that he tagged me in that post. He says, this is a great compliment for you. And because he tagged me, I had the notification on my Facebook personal page. Then I went quickly to that and I saw this letter, and it was a really touching letter. So I feel I'm on the right path. I have a personal page with which I connect with family and friends all over the world, because it's kind of instant. If I'm online at the same time as my friends and my family are, and we chat on Facebook straight away, or we send instant messages. My personal page is my personal page, and Tailspin page is a separate page. Tailspin is wholly and completely dedicated to storytelling, but sometimes I share some photographs or some of my events onto my personal page. I owe a lot of thanks, and I'm really grateful to the social media, especially Facebook, for promoting me so much on online, globally. Because a lot of people in the world have liked the Tailspin page, I have reached as far as Australia, Egypt, and people have messaged me saying, we like what you're doing and all the best to you. Some of them have even mentioned the comments under, because that is, I have put some privacy settings on Tailspin page, but pretty much you can comment on, you can post your comments, and it's been very encouraging. And I have become known to many people here through Facebook. Just the other day at the Children's Center, there was another storyteller who was pitching her stories on Janmashtami for 3 to 4 year olds, you know, right above me. And before she started her event, she came and said, you are I've heard so much about you and I have seen your pages and I'm so glad I met you in person. You know, things like this, it really touches my heart. And I don't think I would have become as famous as I am today, if I may use that word very humbly, of course, if not for Facebook. I owe a lot to that. So thank you, Mark Zuckerberg, for bringing Facebook to me.
For Usha, Facebook helped her build a personal brand and develop her storytelling initiative into a successful business venture. But there are some housewives who run a small-time business from their houses through WhatsApp.
In big groups, somebody wants to sell something, then they click the photograph of that thing and they put in WhatsApp. And even the name and contact person, building number. So if somebody like it, they can call them directly and buy that. So it's easier for them to sell things. One of my friends does earrings business, jewelry business. So she clicked the photograph of some few earrings and she puts in WhatsApp. So many people liked it, and maybe somebody has bought it also through WhatsApp only. And even some ladies are doing snacks item that making. So they click the photograph of snacks of the day. One day, one snack. So they click the photograph, they put in WhatsApp, and whoever wants to buy, they can call them directly. So this is very helpful for those ladies who are doing business at home.
For most people, sharing jokes through social media creates moments of laughter and provides an outlet for fun in the midst of a day of mundane domestic routine. But for one migrant woman, it also serves as a tool for instantly reliving her distant nativity in a foreign soil.
Somebody has sent some jokes. Jokes they are not making. It is in circulation. So they posted. So we will put comment on that joke, and on that comment again the other friend will comment on that, and it keeps on going and going, and it becomes so hilarious, means more than that joke itself. And sometimes the jokes are boring, but the comments are so interesting that it becomes a very big thing. So it's very hilarious, very fun. Jokes are in circulation. And even for this Modi, when that elections were going on, that so many jokes on the Modi, not jokes, it will say Apki Bar Modi Sarkar. So it become all picture used to come, means so many things, means morning till night we used to get this type of for Modi Sarkar, so much campaigning for Modi Sarkar in WhatsApp itself. So so means they are using WhatsApp. So it's very, means then we used to comment on that also. Those who are in favor of BJP, then we used to like pulling them and all. It was a great thing. We are very far from Punjab, and I am not in touch of Punjab. So those who are going in Punjab, they send, they get from there. So many relatives are there, so they get jokes from there. So they are sending us in this. So it feels very good that we are getting some Punjabi, because Punjabis are very famous for these jokes and comedy. If you go in Punjab, na, anybody's house, if youngsters are there, whatever, they will joke, they will laugh and all. They are very jolly good fellow time. So that jokes are coming when they send, then it feels very good, because from past so many years we are not going to Punjab. So we are not in touch of Punjab at all. So this feel great for me that, okay, some jokes are coming. Wow, very good.
Yes, for Sindhu, the circulation of jokes on WhatsApp not only lightens her mood, but also helps her momentarily reconnect with her Punjabi roots. Polymedia is an anthropological notion that was introduced by Daniel Miller and Mirka Madiano in recognition of the way most individuals use a wide variety of communication media for different purposes. The following interviews shed light on this concept.
Mostly na Facebook edhuke use pandra appadina vachingala enoda friends enoda college mates enoda colleague அவங்க என்னெல்லாம் பிக்சர் அப்டேட் பண்ணாங்க அவங்களோட ஸ்டேட்டஸ் என்ன அப்டேட் எல்லாத்தையுமே நான் பார்க்குறதுக்கு வந்து மோஸ்ட்லி யூஸ் பண்ணுவேன். எனக்கு ஒரு சோசியல் ரிலேட்டடான இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் வருது நான் ஃபேஸ்புக்கில் லைக்கோ ஷேரோ பண்ணுறது என்னுடைய வழக்கம் இந்த ஃபேஸ்புக்கில். ஸோ ஃபேஸ்புக்கை தாண்டி இவ்வளோ தான் நான் ஃபேஸ்புக்கில் யூஸ் பண்ணேன். சாட் பண்ணுறதுக்கு நான் ஃபேஸ்புக் மோஸ்ட்லி யூஸ் பண்ண மாட்டேன், ஏன்னா நான் வாட்ஸ்அப் யூஸ் பண்ணிகிட்ருக்கேன். ஸோ என் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் கூட நான் ஏதாவது டாக் பண்ணோம் சாட் பண்ணோம் அப்படின்னும் போது வாட்ஸ்அப் யூஸ் பண்ணுவேன். ஏதாவது இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் ஷேர் பண்ணுறதுக்கு, ஒரு வெட்டிங் இன்வைட் பண்ணுறதுக்கு, எனி ஃபங்க்ஷனல் ஏதாவது இன்வைட் பண்ணுறதுக்கு நான் வாட்ஸ்அப் அது மாதிரி யூஸ் பண்ணுறதுக்கு. ஆல்சோ ஐ ஷேர் சம் பிக்சர் வயா த வாட்ஸ்அப். எதுக்கு நான் லிங்க்டின்ல லாகின் பண்ண அப்படின்னா, ஸோ மோஸ்ட்லி த ப்ரொஃபஷனல் திங்ஸ் கோசம் நான் லாகின் பண்ணாது. என்ன ப்ரொஃபஷனலாக என்னுடைய ப்ரொஃபைல் அப்டேட் பண்ணேன் ஃபஸ்ட்டு. அதுக்கப்புறம் தான் தெரிஞ்சது த லிங்க்டின் நாட் ஓன்லி ஃபார் அப்டேட்டிங் த ப்ரொஃபைல், ஸோ தேர் ஆர் லாட் ஆஃப் குரூப் இஸ் தர். நான் ஐம் ஒர்க்கிங் ஆஸ் த ஸ்டோரேஜ் அட்மின், ஸோ ஐ நீட் மோர் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் டு த அதர் பீப்புள் அவுட். எனக்கு வேறு வழி தெரியல எப்படி எடுக்கலாம் அப்படின்னு பார்க்கும்போது, ஸோ லிங்க்டின்ல ஒரு குரூப் ஓப்பன் பண்ணேன். தட் குரூப் வாஸ் அ விமேக்ஸ், பிகாஸ் ஸ்பெசிஃபிக் மேஜர் திங்ஸ் ஐம் ஒர்க்கிங் இன் விமேக்ஸ். ஸோ ஐ லாக்இன் தட் விமேக்ஸ், ஸோ ஐ காட் மோர் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன். எது மாதிரி இன்ஃபர்மேஷன்னா, எனக்கு வந்து நாட் ஓன்லி தட் இந்தியன் பீப்புள், ஸோ யூகே யூஎஸ் அங்கிருந்தெல்லாம் எனக்கு வந்து தே வில் ஷேர் த இன்ஃபர்மேஷன்ஸ் அப் டு டேட் என்னெல்லாம் அதில் வந்து அப்டேட் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்காங்க அந்த ஸ்டோரேஜ் பாக்ஸை, அந்த மாதிரி இன்ஃபர்மேஷன்லாம் எனக்கு வர ஆரம்பிச்சிது. ஸோ ஐ வில் ஷேர் த இன்ஃபர்மேஷன், அவங்க எனக்கு என்னென்ன இன்புட் கொடுக்குற எல்லாமே எனக்கு வந்து டே டு டே ஆக்டிவிட்டிக்கு எனக்கு யூஸ்ஃபுல்லாக இருந்தது. ஸோ லிங்க்டின்ல எனக்கு வந்து இது மாதிரி இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் ஷேர் பண்ண ரொம்ப ரியலி எனக்கு வந்து ரொம்ப யூஸ்ஃபுல்லாக இருந்தது. ஸோ இந்த லிங்க்டனுக்கு அப்புறம் எனக்கு இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் ஷேர் பண்ணும்போது அடுத்து நான் யூஸ் பண்ண ஸ்கைப்போட டீம் வியூவர்ன்ற ரெண்டு யூஸ் பண்ணேன். நான் இந்த டீம் வியூவர் வந்து எனக்கு என்ன பண்ணேன்னா, எனக்கு வந்து ஒரு 7 இயர்ஸ் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் ஆன பிறகு எனக்கு வந்து நிறைய ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ்கிட்ட இருந்த ரெக்வஸ்ட் வந்தது. எனக்கு அவங்க வந்து தே ரியலி த இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட் டு லேர்ன் த ஸ்டோரேஜ் ஈவன் சமோதோ. எனக்கு வந்து அந்த ரெக்வஸ்ட் வரனால எனக்கு தே வில் ஐ மீன் தேர் நேட்டிவ் பிளேஸ் இஸ் ஹைதராபாத் அண்ட் பெங்களூர். என்னால் டேரெக்டாக போயிட்டு எனக்கு வந்து கோச் பண்ண முடியல. ஸோ அந்த டைமில் எனக்கு வந்து ஸ்கைப் அண்ட் டீம் வியூவர் ரொம்ப யூஸ்ஃபுல்லாக இருந்தது. ஸோ ஐ ஓப்பன் தட் அக்கௌண்ட் இன் ஸ்கைப் அண்ட் டீம் வியூவர். டீம் வியூவர் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா அது எனக்கு என்னென்னா, ஸ்கைப்பில் எடுத்தோம்னா எனக்கு வந்து கொஞ்சம் டெஸ்க்டாப் ஸ்பீடு எனக்கு இருக்காது. ஸோ என்னால் மானிட்டர் பண்ண முடியாதனால டீம் வியூவர் யூஸ் பண்ணேன். இந்த டீம் வியூவர் வந்து ரொம்ப யூஸ்ஃபுல்லாக இருந்தால் அவங்களுக்கு என்னுடைய மானிட்டர் ஷோ பண்ணுறதுக்கு எனக்கு ஈஸியாக இருந்தது, அதனால் டீம் வியூவர் யூஸ் பண்ணி. ஸோ அதுமாதிரி நான் வந்து நிறைய பேர் ட்ரெயின் பண்ணுறதுக்கோசம் கோச்சிங் பண்ணுறதுக்கு இதான் மோர் தென் 10 பீப்புள் நான் ட்ரெயின் பண்ணியிருக்கேன் இது வரைக்கும். ஸோ அதில் ஒரு சக்ஸஸ்ஃபுல்லாக ஒரு 3-4% இட் காட் த ஜாப் இன் எம்என்சி கம்பெனி. ஸோ இது மாதிரி எனக்கு டே டு டே இது மாதிரி வீக்கெண்ட்ஸில் வந்து நான் மற்றவங்களுக்கு ட்ரெயின் பண்ணுறதுக்கு வந்து இந்த சோசியல் மீடியா ஸ்கைப் அண்ட் டீம் ரொம்ப யூஸ்ஃபுல்லாக இருந்தது. ஸோ இதை தவிர என்னென்னா ட்விட்டர் நான் ஓப்பன் பண்ணேன், பட் நான் வந்து அது வந்து ஆக்டிவ் யூஸராக இல்லை, பட் ஜஸ்ட் ஐம் ஃபாலோ தல் நான் ஃபாலோ மட்டும் தான் பண்ணுவேன். எனக்கு பிடிச்சவங்களை வந்து நான் ஃபாலோ பண்ணிகிட்ருக்கேன், அதில் ஒரு 3-4 பேர் நான் ஃபாலோ பண்ணிகிட்ருக்கேன். ஸோ இந்த ட்விட்டர் வந்து நான் மோஸ்ட்லி நான் வந்து என்னுடைய ட்விட் நான் எதுவுமே ட்விட் பண்ணுறது கிடையாது. ஸோ ஜஸ்ட் ஐம் ரீடிங் தட் மெசேஜ் வாட் தே ஆர் டூயிங், தட்ஸ் இட். திஸ் இஸ் மை சோசியல் மீடியான்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா இவ்வளோ அப்ளிகேஷன் எனக்கு யூஸ்ஃபுல்லாக இருக்கு.
யா ஐ எம் ஆன் ஃபேஸ்புக், ஐ எம் குவைட் ஆக்டிவ் ஆன் ஃபேஸ்புக் ஆல்சோ. ஃபேஸ்புக் இஸ் அ டிஃப்ரெண்ட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் அ ஃபோரம் வேர் யூ நோ எவ்ரிபடி ஹூ இஸ் ஆன் த ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் லிஸ்ட். மேபி ஹீ இஸ் அ ஃப்ரெண்ட், ஷீ இஸ் அ ஃப்ரெண்ட் ஆர் நாட். இஃப் தே ஆர் இன் யர் லிஸ்ட், தே கேன் வியூ வாட் இஸ் ஹேப்பனிங் இன் யர் லைஃப் அண்ட் தே கேன் வியூ. இட்ஸ் லைக் அ ஓப்பன் ஃபோரம் பிகாஸ் யூ வி ஜென்ரலி போஸ்ட் ஆன் த வால்.
So that is not a quite a, what to say, it's open for all. So I would not like to communicate much on Facebook other than the general topics. Many people do post their day-to-day lifestyle, their mood swings, their what is happening in their life, they post. But I do not believe in doing that. If somebody is upset, they would also write that today I am down and depressed. Of course, they might be venting it out in that way. I don't mind reading that, but for me, I don't like to share every moment of the life of mine on a page where, you know, everybody is reading. Because everybody on the Facebook may not be a very good friend of mine. But definitely I use Facebook for posting photographs. You say I had something exciting and it reaches many people in one time. WhatsApp is generally one-to-one or it is a group based. So, you know, Facebook is like if I have gone for a holiday and I click many pictures, I want all my friends to see what I did and I had fun, I would definitely post it on WhatsApp. On Facebook rather than WhatsApp. YouTube is very good for, as far as I use, is for music, to see music videos and listening to songs. And whenever I remember of any good song or you know, something like that, and I want to see how the video is, I would go to YouTube for music.
To understand why a particular social media becomes a preferred one against another, let us listen to what these women have to say.
Past 1.5 years I am using this WhatsApp. Actually, I am not very Facebook and Twitter. I don't like Facebook and Twitter at all. Twitter though I am not in. Facebook just now started only, I think from past 1 year only. My son downloaded it because of some games. They used to play some games and they need Facebook some account. But after that, everybody sent me that request, friend request, and I had to accept because you can't say no. So it started like that only. Not too much actually, very less. Only photographs of birthdays and that's all only. Very less in Facebook I am. But nowadays my friends, they click the photo and they put in Facebook, in group, like group photos. If we are going for lunch, they will click photo, they will put. I'm not putting, but they will put. After 2 days, after 3 days, like that only. When that notification will come there, then only I'll go. And I'll see whoever put that something, some photographs and all, then only. Otherwise, we don't have time. WhatsApp is there. Facebook is very far actually. WhatsApp is much, much easier for us. No, not necessary. I'm telling you, I'm not sending requests. Requests are coming to me only. I have never sent any request to anybody for WhatsApp, for Facebook. So they are requesting me, okay, I'm accepting. Otherwise, I'm not that Facebook person. I'm WhatsApp person only.
Nowadays, I hardly SMS at all because first of all, WhatsApp comes free of cost in the sense that we are having a Wi-Fi in the house. We are connected, which we have to pay a minimum money every month. So if I SMS, I would spend 1 rupee per SMS extra. So since it is almost like a free of cost, so of course we always message through WhatsApp only, not by SMS. And even if it comes for a nominal charge, I think maximum of us are already addicted towards it. Addicted in the sense that it has become a necessity of life. It is not that we are only having fun in it. It has become a necessity because we feel very happy when we talk to old friends and people whom we were not lost touch from years. So for that, even if we have to pay a small amount, I don't think so, I would mind.
There are about 10 boys in my village who have Facebook. Even if they do not know how to use it, they want to have it. When they see me using Facebook and befriending girls, they immediately ask me to create an account for them as well. They too want to be connected with girls. That's it. Many a time, they just keep the Facebook account page open and don't even use it. The moment they receive a hi from a girl, they will immediately rush to boast about it to me. See, I too have 8 girlfriends.
I don't believe that Facebook is a measure of friendship, because what Facebook has become today is just like connecting to your, not exactly friends, just acquaintances. So what friendship really is the bond that you share personally, face to face, or through a connection that you share your feelings and your experiences. That is friendship. What you do through Facebook is not exactly friendship, it's more of just talking and letting each other know how your life is going on.
Within the e-space of Facebook, a student can choose to exercise their personal right of privacy by not befriending the teachers, who they are friends with, what they like, who they hang out with, what they share. Their likes and dislikes are not for the eyes of the teacher.
I really don't want my teachers to have an inkling about what I do outside of school, because I have my own personal likes and interests, and I don't want that to influence their thinking of me as a person. My reputation shouldn't be tarnished just because of what I follow on Facebook. That really has no connection to the school or whatsoever. My old school principal sent me a request. So I accepted her request because one, she was a really nice person and I knew she wouldn't judge me based on just that. But then there are lots of teachers I do not know very well. I knew the principal personally, so she was a really nice person. But the other teachers, I don't know them, so I wouldn't accept their request. My password is something I believe is only for my knowledge, not even with my parents.
Facebook, I don't like that. Anybody can watch you. Anybody can see your photographs through anybody's profile. If I have friend list, so I can go to their profile pics. Anybody can go to anybody's profile pics. There is no safety, I think. I don't know about that. So I don't like that. In WhatsApp, if 13 people are there, only 13 are there. No other can see our joke. So that is the thing which I like. For WhatsApp.
WhatsApp is like you have to share your number for that. So I do it only to a few of my select friends. I don't just share my number to everybody, because then they start adding me in groups and spam. And so I don't really like that. So I give my number to only a few people, and I talk to those people privately on WhatsApp, because otherwise I don't want to give my number to every person who asks for it.
The Indian housewife is quite often surprised by uninvited guests at her doorstep. Let us see how Sindhu handles such guests in her social media world.
If you have contact number, if I have WhatsApp or if they have WhatsApp, then you don't have to invite them. It is automatic. It will automatically come in your WhatsApp list. So once suddenly in morning I saw my car cleaner is in WhatsApp, and I got shocked. What is that? Then I deleted his number from my contact list. When you will delete from contact list, then it will go. Otherwise it will not go. You can block that, but in blockage also he can see your DP, that display pictures in WhatsApp. So I deleted from contact, then it goes. So this is very dangerous also, because you have given so many, your number to so many person, anywhere, this plumber, carpenter and all, if they will come in WhatsApp, then it's dangerous because they can see our photos. So I don't like, so I deleted that.
While social media has brought several positive transformations in people's lives, it is not without a downside. Social media sometimes poses serious challenges to its users.
Disadvantages in paakumbodhu nama nariya kuzhandhaigalukku advice pannuvom nariya phone la irukada eppa paathala adu nondada appadi ana most of the time naangale nondinna irukom adha.
The family time goes. A lot of family time is getting lost because of the social networking. In the sense, because we have got so connected with people, so if a friend connects us, messages, we don't reply, means we have got quite addicted to this.
So I feel the family time is getting hampered a lot. Sometimes, you know, if I'm sitting with my daughter teaching her something, and if I am getting a ping of many messages coming back to back when, you know, the mobile gives a message tone, notification tone. So I get very restless to see who has messaged. So in that case, that when I'm getting restless, my concentration from the child's study is actually going towards the mobile phone. So which is not good in a long run. I sometimes feel guilty about it. As well as since I'm working and I'm going for my office work, so if I don't get time in the day, I would sit in the night and read the messages, which is spoiling my sleeping time. I'm sleeping very late in the night, which makes me tired in the morning because I have to get up in the morning for the family chores and for the child to go to school. So I'm feeling my family life is getting a little disturbed because of this.
As far as I know, no bullying has actually happened within my friend circle. It's always an outsider or someone. And if I know the person who is getting bullied or is doing the bullying, I would strongly encourage them to either stop or react in a sensible way. There was this thing in Mumbai where I ran into a friend of mine and he told me of something like that going on with him. He was getting bullied by some people, some seniors of his school. So I asked him to tell his parents about it and not send them a message or directly react in a way that wouldn't be sensible for him to do. Because since he was only in 8th grade at that point, it's not wise to pick a fight with the seniors. There was this one case I heard where people befriending women on Facebook, they don't actually know them personally, but then just send a random request. These people, the way Facebook goes, you just accept any request that comes to you. So they just, they accept the request. And then these two, the two people start talking. They don't even know each other, but they start talking. And then the guy invites the girl for meeting in some place. And then she probably gets kidnapped or something, and then they send a ransom letter home, stuff like that.
As you can see, whether it is the temptation of accepting invitations from strangers or addictively responding to the message tones, social media poses some dilemmas for its users. In ancient times, messenger birds were used as communication tools and delivery services. But in this age of technology, there is a wide range of communication and networking tools to choose from. Droves of people have shifted to social media networking from their email groups. However, there are still a few who hold on to their old communication habits through email. Here is an interesting example of a person who clings to his Yahoo email group for social networking and sharing knowledge.
I'm 64. I'm actually new to social media. I can't claim that I know much about social media, except that I keep seeing emails, receiving emails and sending emails. There are a number of emails that I receive which I forward to my friends and relatives. In fact, I'm surprised that a few of the emails contain information that even other media do not cover. They are so interesting that I receive very good responses from my associates. And that is one of the best proofs that they go through that, they appreciate that. Although they are such a group constitutes a minority, I really feel satisfied and happy that some others are able to enjoy the messages that I get in the same way that I enjoy. Forwarding emails is one of the ways that I'm able to communicate, especially those emails where my views converge, is one of the ways of conveying my own thoughts and feelings about certain things. I have a group of about 40 to 50 guys and ladies with whom I share the email messages that I receive. And I have been doing this for the last 10 years or so. I feel really gratified when a few of them respond and appreciate the messages that I forward. See, the type of messages that I receive varies naturally in content and also in style. For example, I receive a number of jokes, both in English and in other Indian languages. I receive a number of pictures, but mostly it is the text that I am interested in, which I forward to my group. Some of these texts are really wonderful. Any person who has the habit of reading will find it very interesting and useful also. A number of medical tips also we receive through email. Although it is generally believed that everything that comes in email is not credible. And it's an interesting hobby that I have. And although I am not otherwise very busy with social media, this medium of sending medium of computers which I use to send, forward my emails and receive email, is very useful and very interesting. Although I am 64 now, I am still active in corporate service, so I don't really find time to indulge in any social media like Facebook. I do see emails officially, so officially it's part of my job. So incidentally, I also happen to see some of the emails which are not official but which are generally useful to anyone, and irrespective of the age group, they find it interesting. In fact, in my group of 40-50 persons, there are a number of youngsters, there are a few of them who are on the wrong side of 70. Most of them are, of course, of middle age. So generally, I find this exercise very invigorating and healthy, rather than wasting our time in looking at some pictures. I do share pictures of nature, pictures of cars, then pictures of buildings and gardens and whatnot. Everything, I do that, but still, while they have entertainment value, I feel forwarding texts can really make a difference in somebody's life. For example, I used to forward messages to a divorcee, and she used to appreciate the messages and she used to respond also. So I really believe that it serves a social purpose in the type of diverse group, category comprised in this group. Generally, you cannot categorize people who respond into old or young. Some old people do respond to me, some youngsters also do respond. It's also a proof that they go through the email that you forward. Some of them may be probably deleting it also, without even reading it or without even going through that. Maybe they find it too offensive to tell me not to forward any email. Definitely, quite a few persons may belong to this category also. But generally, a majority of them, I'm sure, they go through the emails. And once in a while, what I do is I stop sending emails to a particular segment of the group. It is not a specific segment as such, whom I believe may not go through the mails that I forward, so I stop sending them. And when you hear back from them, why these days you are not sending any email, it's a clear proof that they do go through the emails that you forward. So I keep adopting this deliberately once in a while to find out the response to my emails. Yeah, it's possible that I may get busy with other social media. Basically, I'm interested in education, although I work in a corporate. So I would like to forward mails and receive mails connected with education, which will be useful to my students, which will be useful to the faculty. I also happen to be a correspondent of a college run by my company. So from their point of view, I would like to use other social media also for their benefit. Off and on, what I do is I have a few friends living abroad. I create a facility through their help of some of the foreign scientists and experts in a particular subject, lecturing to our students in our college through email, through internet. And our college faculty and students find it very useful and very interesting. Anything that is away from the ordinary is interesting to all of us. So that way, it's a new exercise that we have initiated in our college for the benefit of our faculty and students. It is possible I may move on to Facebook and other social media in future, depending on the time available. I don't expect to be active career-wise, say after 2-3 years. So when it is possible that I may move on to other social media.
While millions of people use social media, what is fascinating is that it has permeated the nooks and corners of villages that do not even have roads, electricity, and proper sanitation. Social media has found a place even in the grimy hands of a cowherd and the muddy fingers of a farm worker.
My family consists of 4 of us, my father, mother, sister, and myself. My sister is an undergraduate student in biochemistry, and I am an undergraduate student in computer science. I use a Micromax smartphone. I have a Facebook, Gmail, and more recently, a YouTube account. I access them when I am at home, on my way to college, and during my free time at night. I like Facebook a lot because in Gmail, I can only convey my thoughts through text, but in Facebook, I can also send videos. I have about 67 friends on Facebook. None of my Facebook friends belong to this neighborhood, as the folks in my village are not aware of social media.
சோஷியல் மீடியால இன்ட்ரஸ்ட் யாரும் காட்டல.
The girls here are not on Facebook, as most of them are not educated. I have recently changed my profile picture on Facebook. I also chat with my friends on Facebook during my free time. I exchange about 40 chat messages during these online interactions. I also like and unlike posts. I have uploaded 2 videos. I also comment a lot on others' posts. I once joined a history study group of 40 members. This is a preparation for a common government examination. I friended 2 members and shared some study materials with them.
He does not allow his sister to use the mobile phone to be on social media.
I have seen in many cinemas and in real life how these things can influence a girl to take a wrong path. You can talk about women's rights and all that, but her responsibility to honor the family's reputation is what's important for me. I fear that her befriending strangers on social media from other communities may tarnish the name of my family. My house has one small hall, a small kitchen area, very few shelves to keep my books and clothes. We do not have electricity. We do not have toilet facilities either. The forest that you see in the background? That's my toilet. However, I have access to Facebook. I access it through my mobile phone and my USB. My mother and I, we watch films at night in my laptop. She dozes off while watching it. I download films from YouTube for her. My grandmother too enjoys watching old film songs when she visits us. This is a movie song that I have downloaded in my phone. I will now show you my downloads. I use Bluetooth for getting songs from my friends. This is an application that I have downloaded. It is being installed. I use this for downloading songs. See, I have so many songs. All are videos of film songs. I don't have any movies, only songs. I have 50 folders of video songs. See, another video song. I download from various websites such as Tamilanda, Tamil Mini, and so on. I am a farmer. I do farming all year round. I grow rice, sugarcane, groundnuts, and chilies. Apart from these, I also grow millets, sesame, and eggplants. I harvest about 90 bags of rice in 3 acres of land. Each of us in my family has a mobile phone. I have also bought my son a laptop. See here, this is Facebook. Here you can find people from all across the world being connected. Here all kinds of people, white people, Americans, our Tamil people and people of different castes can all be friends with one another. We're all using this Facebook today. I have an account and so does your son. In my account, I have my photos and my details. Your son's account will have his photos and his details. This is something that brings everybody in society together. Ever since I was young, I have not seen any bus transportation or hospitals in my village. In another 2 years, we are expecting that modernization will bring all this to us. Even when I was going to school, I had to walk a long distance to get to school. I have to walk at least 4 kilometers to catch a bus. But all of us boys have a mobile phone and many have a motorbike. I have been using Facebook account for 3 years. I access it about 3 to 4 times a week. In my Facebook account, I have about 60 girls and 40 boys as friends. I have more girls as friends because they are a great source of entertainment for me. Boys are boring as they do not respond as well as girls. It's so much more entertaining to chat with girls. I myself will not respond to boys unless they are very close to me.
In the Hindu mythological world, Lord Krishna was depicted as a cowherd who played bewitching music on his flute that mesmerized the village maidens. In this film, our new age cowherd amuses himself while tending his grazing cow by enticing his girlfriends in the virtual world of Facebook. Throughout this film, we have seen how various users of social media have employed it in their lives. While Anita uses WhatsApp to forge sisterly bonds with her new neighbors, Nina uses Google Chat to sustain overseas relationships with her family members. While Sindhu uses WhatsApp as a medium for pursuing an electronic hobby of collecting art images of all sorts, Usha uses Facebook to follow her passion of reviving the ancient art of storytelling. While Kathy uses WhatsApp to train her friends in colloquial slangs, Vasu uses Skype for providing vocational training for youngsters. While Arya uses YouTube to watch highlights of events that he had missed while away at school, Pooja uses YouTube to learn Bollywood dancing at home during her free time after school hours. While Krishna uses Facebook to entertain himself by chatting with girls while tending grazing cattle, Raja accesses YouTube on his laptop to bring an all-time favorite Tamil movie to his mother's lap. While Nina has been nicknamed as a social media junkie due to her unrestrained use of social media, her husband conservatively sticks to networking through his email. So, as you can see, it takes all kinds of activities, a whole host of emotions, and all sorts of people to make up the world of social networking.